Back to Poi. Well, last time we went to the place with all the fire, and unfortunately a glitch prevented us from collecting the final collectible. Am I gonna do Shifting Sands first or the Bird Lady? Let's just do Shifting Sands. Oh, let's just do the bird. Let's just get let's just get the really awkward. Let's get the ice physics out of the way first, cause oh boy, I'm just looking forward to a 3D ice physics level. Those are just the best. Wait a minute, there's already one baby bird back. Oh, such a happy little baby! Look at this happy little baby! Aw, oh, they look adorable. The big old puffs. I love big old puffs. I like how the ice... the platform... why? Look at all these babies. All the little puffs. I picked up a coin. Now the real question is, where are all the babies at? Where will I find all these mysterious babies? Can I collect 100 coins here? Hey, there's one of the babies. Come here, you. Oh, I'll catch you. Yeah, I kicked your ass. You better go home now, baby. Your mama's very, very upset. The fact that you just went to this horrible place of death and destruction. Filled with mysterious bomb yetis. Oh, no, they're lightning yetis. I don't know if that's... the heck? Why is there a mysterious floating metal? No, I really want to know, why is there a mysterious floating metal? I want to get that now. The ice looks nice, but I can for the life of me not tolerate it. Is there one more baby out here? Got a medal. Oh, it just kicks me out. It's just like, ah, I did enough. Oh, look, I collected all the babies. But there's still another medal to collect. So do the babies stay collected? Are there no more collectible babies now? Yeah. That's weird. It's like it's just a random bunch of babies out here. It's really awkward to have multi-jumps like that, but also, for some reason, have... like, triple jumps and multi-jumps like that, they always interact a bit odd. They're very weird to get used to. I don't know why. It's just... one of them you can do anywhere in a jump, and the other one you have to do just after you land, and it creates this weird conflict of interest. I guess is how you could call it. Oh, look, there are... wow. Pushable boxes that actually turn. Those you don't see every day in video games nowadays. Welcome to Snowland. This random sign points you in the direction of nothing of interest. Actually, now that you mention it, I haven't turned on my binoculars. I keep forgetting which button is which. I'm gonna get in there, though. Oh, I can make that. I can make that. I just have to believe in myself. If I just believe in myself. See? All you have to do is believe. You know, in smaller levels like this, I would actually really like it if there were exactly 100 coins to collect and a couple of coins you can get off of enemies. You know? Make it a really tight scavenger hunt. Oh, wow, there's coins in grass? Oh, that's cool. That's a neat little feature. Like, it's a gimmick. It's just like, but you know, little baby touches like that. Add that little extra sparkle to my day, which is really bad right now. That's cool. So are they set coins, or are they, like, random spawns? This is an important question with a very important answer. They're probably set. Or to some extent, like, every grass patch randomly has a sign. I don't know. Aha! Figured as much. So there's 100... wow, there's a lot of medals in this one bonus area. There's already a medal up here. Oh, no, that's just a dude. Oh, there is a medal up here. I'm gonna get that one first, then. All right. I got a medal! I hope you weren't expecting anything. This girl, by the way, is underdressed. Very underdressed for the circumstances. I think just for this level, we should go back to the kid who's defying all laws of fashion by wearing denim on denim like that. Oh, I just... Oh, I'm supposed to tolerate that. I'm supposed to play a game where one of the protagonists just casually wears denim on denim. Look at that. For one, it really creates a bland palette. That's one of the reasons I really hate denim, is that it's so often... It's just blue. Like, fuck you. Sorry for that. I wanted to keep this as PG as possible, but I really don't like it. I really don't. I really don't. Like the neckerchief adds that little brilliant splash of color in an otherwise very drab character design. He looks very bland with the white and the relatively muted dark blue and then the beige hat. Like the glasses pop out a bit, you know? He feels a little flat. Ow. That being said, Banjo was a pretty flat character design with the dark blue and the otherwise very brown skin. Like, not even an interesting color brown, just brown. Although the yellow shorts kind of popped. I guess the yellow shorts really made him pop. That's what really brought him out into the world as its own person. And so, as a person that's supposed to be... Oh, that's cute. That's really cute. If you can't afford actual propeller models, you might as well do that, then. There was something really big up there, and I think it was 100. But no, it was probably just the two tenors that interfered. Well, that's neat. Under the snow tree! Oh, actually, we should have looked at the leaderboards. But hey, let's go to snow area 2. We're gonna collect more babies! Oh, that's cute! Oh, I love it! I love the little cart wagons. Also, this snow tune is very, very chill. Get it? It's chill! Oh, it's a joke. I hope you like jokes. That bird likes jokes. That's why he's here. Let's get the 100 coin out of the way first. It's a good way to explore the level and get to know it. It depends on what kind of level you're playing. If you're playing a big open level, you want to save it until later because you're probably going to go everywhere. But here it seems like there's really like three medals. There's the one special, there's the coins, and then there's the location. And that seems to still be holding up. And in that case, it's better if I just... Yeah, there's still that flying medal. So it's just better if I do the 100 coin first. Just get to know the level, no? Really get that smooth touch and feel. Enjoy the rich texture this map has to offer. Although they could do with a few less icy surfaces. This is a nice snowy tune without being too stereotypically snowy, you know? You know? You know, like this... God, I can't make that. No, I can. Because I'm smart. Wait, you can climb trees? Oh, that's cool. As in cool. I need to go up there, so I might want to procrastinate going a little too high for now. This game has a lot of things on it. It's not complete yet. Like, it doesn't feel cohesive as one giant product, but you know. There's a lot of little things already. A lot of splishes and splashes, as they say. Is that bird collected yet? Oh, no, he hasn't. Oh, you come back here, birdie. Oh, so there are invisible walls. That's good to know. Which reminds me, there's one more birdo to collect then. There's the coin medal. But before we collect that final bird. You know what I would have really liked? Ice skates upgrades. Like, one thing you rarely see in games is a way to make ice bearable. Very rarely is there, like, a way past it. Maybe puzzle games, I guess. Puzzle games often do that. Where's the final birdo? There, I saw a birdo. And he certainly doesn't look collected. Oh, he is collected. Oh, well. Then where's the final birdo at? Is that the birdo? Or have I collected them all already? I guess I have them already, then. I guess I just have a really really bad memory today. A I better beat the level before I die. Yeah! Collecting them also removes them from the map, so that's good. Wow! Revenge for Wanda. I will avenge you, Wanda! Yeah, I got all the birdos. Thanks for returning all my babies. For some reason, the only currency in this world is an old man's lost medals. Don't ask me! All penguins saved. That's gotta be the top 10. That was Spiff McBiff. I'm number 6!
Yeah!
Wow, you can do that in 4 seconds flat? That's pretty spiffy. Hi, old man. Listen, old man, I don't care about storm. Rain or shine! I wonder what they are about. Like, what the whole point is of these teleport machiggers. What's their deal in this world? Like, in the other times, you fly over to a locale, right? Like, there's an in-world explanation as to how you get there, but here it just feels... Okay. Ha-ha! Sorry about my language, I just had a really bad day. So it takes a little bit of extra effort to get my mind to focus. Well, there's the storm. I sure hope so, old man. Because I'm really not appreciating the weather. How about instead of shifting sands, we go and do some more of those challenge missions? Because now do we have the money to pay for it? Oh, I see. We unlocked another level, didn't we? I wonder if he even operates during the storm.
Hey.
I know it's financially irresponsible to send kids out in this weather, but if you got the money, I've got the carelessness. Oh, that looks really great. Oh, that just looks fantastic. Press the button rapidly to escape. Well, this just looks awesome. Oh, man, this is pretty tough. This is pretty stiff. This is a steep order, as they call it. Whew! That's good. That's nice. That would get annoying really fast if you did it for too long. You gotta be careful with those. I'm 15. I like how it says you behind your own... Oh, that's spiffy. It looks like a super evil vortex of evil. Well, I got dunked on really bad. I was about to do another challenge mission too. That looks pretty nice, animation-wise. Like the little blub. We are now in a place of spoops and scares. Once you collect all the collectment abilities, you get a fabulous prize. The prize is I won't tell on you. Hello, old man.
Oh.
I wonder. This looks like I need to get all the medals in all the areas before I can move on. That's fine. Except for the fact that one of the medals is impossible to get due to a glitch. I'm fine with that, but, you know. I can wait it out. If it really is that bad, I'll just wait out the storm, as they say. That's cool. I really appreciate that it gives you an end goal. That's really nice. It's really good to give the player an end goal to work towards. Like Banjo-Kazooie did it with the coin, with the note doors, and then the collecting puzzle pieces for the thing. Mario did it with the star doors. You gotta give the player something to work towards. It can be an end game thing. It can be the post end game. You know, but just give him something.
Hey,
you got some money? I've got this financially irresponsible trade going on. Would you like to be financially irresponsible? Goodbye. Hope you don't mind being dirt poor. What does it say? Collect 8 keys. Aw, really? Who locks their chest with 8 locks? That is financially irresponsible. Oh, this is super, super awkward, by the way. Like, holy banana squeezy. I can't roll either. And I think I know why oh, wow, that is awesome. Why did they do this segment more than once? Like, they did this exact segment twice for some reason. My son died in 1945 when he fell off a mysterious fire vortex platform. One way to go, I guess. Oh! Almost got set ablaze. Almost got 420 blazed. Only in the unpleasant fashion. You got a medal for being financially responsible. What's up, old man? Oh! Oh, I love that! I love crystals. Crystals are so shiny. And this game's got a pretty decent, the ice. The ice looks good. And if the crystals look anywhere as good as the ice, I'm on board. No questions asked. Like, for a game that claims to be in early access, these are pretty worked out environments. Again, needs a lot of polish to be a very good thing. But it's good enough, you know? Like, I don't feel like I misspent my money, is the point. Like, I'm not gonna ask for a refund after this. I'm satisfied. And that's more than some games can say for themselves. Welcome to Sinking Sand! Please stay out of the deadly quicksand that no one's ever gonna bother to clean up. And remember that there's a whole bunch of stuff to collect now. Oh, you dirtbag. Oh, you're a dirtbag. That's all you are. Ha! Hope you like being dead. I like how they're only sharp on top. It's like, you see that beautiful flower? It'll murder you! That's why it's beautiful. Because it murders my son. What a beautiful excuse. Where are we going, anyway? Or are we going to the top of the Windy Tower thing? I think I'm just going to pick up some spare change for later, but that's it. Maybe collect a couple of fossils. There we go. Ooh. That's a fin. Oh, Windfish. That's a cool name. I like that name. A lot less wall jumping here. That's good. That's a good way to tone down my mobility, I guess. Chugga 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 choo 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 choo. I don't think bars of TNT tick like that. It's usually the attached detonator that does that. Why is there a chicken out here in the desert? Couldn't tell you. They just are. How is this not a location to collect? Oh, well, there's a fossil over there. Man, that snake had a bad day. Cause he had a bad day. He took it one down, then he shook it around. Oh, that looks super dangerous. I'm not gonna mess with that. Come here, Metal Man. I'll show you the bottom of my foot. Oh, that's a giant clock! It's not accurate, though. It seems to be coordinated to the in-game time. Danger! Beware of sinking platform. It's safer to find another. That's cute! I love that! I love it when it's like, hey, listen, you can take this super dangerous route, and it's super fast, or you can just take the safe route, you know? You can be a baby! There, see? Managed to cleverly avoid saying some really nasty words. Takes a little bit of mental time and tends to postpone my responses, but you know. Protecting the sanctity of babies is worth it. Ooh, it's a button. I want to push that button. Never underestimate the human desire to push buttons. I assume this is for another mission where you have to get the train going and again. Oh, look at these pretty crystals! Oh, that's cute. That's cute. Okay. We gotta find a way up there. They put a remarkable amount of detail into these structures. It might not look like it, but they really... They gave it a more than a couple of seconds of thought. Because they put in the little cross beams to hold up the second floor. That's a tiny baby detail. Like, you only see in Assassin's Creed, because Assassin's Creed is way too much money and nothing else to do. Hi, ship. How are you doing? How are you doing? Okay, so if I jump down here on the house... Oh! Gotta watch out for the spikes. Legend has it this bell never stopped ringing. And the people that live here are still annoyed by it. Ah, good old-fashioned legends. They sure do make my day. And fill my wallet with candy corn. That took a long while, but I was exploring the level, having a bit of fun, you know? Getting to know the environment. Start old Sally. Oh, that's cute. They gave the train a nice name. Again. Oh, I see you, Naruto. I'll be coming for you later. Oh, let's go for him now. Let's go teach that Naruto a lesson. Thinking he can go and anime up my anime. This game has got good iframes, unlike some other games that I've played. Hello there, Naruto. As your reward. I like how you can get these, even though the mission is not get this. That's nice. You know? Gives me the feeling that I have agency where I might not have any. Forget to start old Sally. In order to do that, you have to push all the buttons. Someone really doesn't like her, so they shut her down. Huh, little obelisk. That's cute. So we gotta find three buttons, because there was a big old light thing. Which I assume means that once we collect all three buttons, we unlock the mystical power of the steam train. These houses, for some reason, remind me a lot of A World of Keflings, which I actually kind of liked. It's only Xbox, though, so... Man, I would play that game. It's not a very exciting game. But, you know, it's a cute little game, and I like cute little games. In case you didn't notice, I like cute little games. I like this. I like this train! I like this train. It's cute. Everyone get aboard the old Choo Choo Express. Chugga 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 Conroy! A Birdodo. Oh, that's neat. If that is actually what I think it is. Oh, look at this kid. He can't do his animation because he's falling. I want to see that Birdodo beak. Let's go have a sneak peek at the Birdodo beak. This kid is taking way too many risks. Like, your grandpa is going to be so upset. There's my Birdodo Island. Oh, it just looks like a... That is a terrifying beak, though. I was hoping that since it said Birdo, it would have been like a reference to it. Oh, that's it. That's not how fossils work! That's not how fossils work! I'll give him credit, since they have actual fossils, that they can do that. You can do that. You can make offhand jokes like that. You can't do it around Grandpa, though. I bet your Grandpa's like, I'm so grumpy that I didn't have more things to sell to my son and extort him for money. Imagine how rich I could have been if I had only more things to bribe my son with. I'll be honest. That really reminds me of Wario Land. Pecan Sands, to be specific. I like Pecan Sands, I guess, maybe. So we need to get up to the crane. I walked into the minecart using my mysterious powers of electro-transportation. How does it work? Don't ask! I won't even answer your question. Okay, so we gotta get up on the crane. I don't even know where the crane is right now. I don't think this song is very appropriate, though. It doesn't feel very sandy. Which is generally how your desert level's music is supposed to sound. Okay, so there's gotta be a way out there, right? That's not how you do that. That's how you get yourself killed. Oh man, I love this. I love how level 3 has giant crane mechanic thing that is probably gonna get you stuck in a wrong place. Okay, I think I know what this is. I need to do a triple jump. This is good. It's good when the player can use their own techniques to pull off stunts like that. That's important. It's also important that you as the player remember how the mechanics work and that you can't double jump in some instances. Also, what is that? Oh, that's a bridge. For some reason, there's a huge bridge up there. Good-dick, good-dick. Little squeaky shoes. Good job. Give him a good old kick in the keister. I wonder what that clock's about. Oh, it's a location we can collect, isn't it? Tick-tock clock. Listen, kiddo. You cannot reference Birdodo. You cannot make a Birdodo, which almost sounds like a reference, and then name something Tick-tock clock, which is an actual Super Mario 64 level. Not a good one, because the biggest problem I have with, I'm not kidding, by the way, I really think the TikTok clock is a bit of a failure of a Mario 64 level. The primary reason for that is the TikTok clock requires you to do the same little area over and over and over again. I appreciate that he does this to sort of inform you, you're standing on a very precarious object. Be careful. And it feels like the character's really there, right? Like if he was just standing casually, be like, ah... My character isn't really looking like he's standing in a very precarious position that can result in a very, very painful encounter with the sand. You know? Like, it doesn't have to be a mechanic, it can just be an animation that plays because you're doing something dumb. Give it a little bit of life. Give it a little bit of life. And it doesn't take away my double jump, which a lot of games for some reason like to do. It's like, oh, you're in a unique situation here, your double jump doesn't work. And you ask why, and it's like, I don't know. Because we're too lazy to program that. I like how this thing is not just precarious for us, but it's precariously hanging from a crane. That is not how you're supposed to balance your stuff. Whoever put this here should be arrested. This is a crime against humanity. And a crime against my skills. That pay all of them bills. Of course, the metal is in the middle of the hyper precarious location.
Awesome.
Very precarious. Let's keep on moving. Let's keep the momentum going. Heart of the sand pit. Oh, I see where to go. Never underestimate my powers. There's a location like right here. Secret Sandfall, huh? That's a good one. That is not a bad one. Oh, whatever. I'll find a legitimate way up there. But can I? Do I have what it takes to be the manly man that I want to be? Or will I forever be a girly girl? Find out next time on I'm a Manly Man, Pinky Promise Swear. That's, by the way, a triple pinky promise. Because you can trust me. I found the this thing is leaky, too. Oh, that's very leaky. By golly. Whoever built that should be fired. That's not how you build a... That's an egg. You will give me an egg. Wait, so now there's a Birdodo. We found a fossil of a Birdodo, but there's also a Birdodo's egg. Because why not, I guess. Well, why not, I guess. Sorry, Mr. Snake. But I must feast upon your delicious heart. And nourish. What the Jiminy Cricket is... Oh, wait, do I stand still here? No? Because funnily enough, that's the thing you could do in Super Mario 64, is there were these weird, random locations. You could just stand still for a moment. And you would teleport to another location. So I thought, hey, maybe it's that. Maybe it's that. Because it's super, super suspicious. You know? But my gut instinct was wrong. Sandosaurus egg. There's a blue button here. Now, what is a boy to do? Oh, am I supposed to push it back? That's what I'm supposed to do. See, I'm clever, too. I can be cleaver. This, by the way, is remarkably good box-pushing abilities. The animation's a bit out of sync. But the control I have is remarkably high compared to most other games, which are a bit fiddly. It's not great, but, you know. The fact that everything is covered in moving sand is a bit off. A bit weird. Ha! Let's go and turn in the pillar. I actually really like that. It's like, oh, you did this easy thing? Here's the real level! Here's the real level for you, kid! Here's the real level. I like this a lot. This is great. Might not be the most difficult puzzle for someone with my sneaky sneak skills, but why not? It's good. I like how the random boxes got picked up along the way. Damn. I mean, gosh, dolly or aren't it. To the Seeking Sands. We've got to do the ancient puzzle. I wonder, the 9th of November. I like how she has this really weird bandolier bag. I've never seen a bag like that, which honestly, kinda neat. That really looks like either a like a bandolier satchel you'd put in the on your side or something, but it really doesn't look like something you'd wear on your back like a backpack, which is what intrigues me about it. You know, it's not conventional design. And those thoughts will. Oh, it's you. It's you, the rude man who thinks he's super clever. I like how the old Sandy's still running because we activated it a long, long while ago. Long, long time ago. Still a lot of locations to collect. I think we'll do that in the 100 coin mission. We'll clean up the whole place. For now, let's focus on this huge bridge. Which I almost call it the huge ass bridge. Well, the first level was a bit bland, but it's gotten better. A little bit like Zack Zero. Zack Zero started off just wow. And then it suddenly got good. I don't know why. It looks like someone invented the rotation puzzle before they invented electricity. I guess they really like their rotation puzzles. Found a lonely Eru Cactusaru. Oh, I'm here. Might as well dig it up. A winged dingus! I love that name. Oh, behold the winged dingus. Let us pray to Dingus Khan. Conqueror of Dingusland. President of Dingustopia. Actually kind of excited to see what Crystal Land looks like. I think these gears are oddly pulsing. Can you please invent electricity? Not until I'm done with my rotation puzzle! But I want to have electricity, and I want a rotation puzzle. You can't win them all, boy. You can't win them all. Oh, it auto-snaps. That's good. And so comes the mysterious platform. I don't know how Grandfather managed to lose an Explorer Medal there, but I'll give him kudos for losing things in ordinary places. Time to collect them all. Here's a sparkly medal that we couldn't bother to frame in the center of the frame. Ah, that's polish. That's polish. Polish is making existing things better. And that's something you gotta do where you have the time and the money for it. Huh. Ah, oh, that's so sneaky! Oh, that's so sneaky. There's a ladder in the back. Ah, oh, I love it. I love it. I love how it's a location too, so if you're super curious, you can find that one early. And you have it in your back pocket. I need to get up there, which means getting up on the big crane. Gotta keep a good eye on my detectometer. On my detectometer. It's detecting something! What is it detecting? I don't know! It just says that it's detecting something! That's what detectometers do! They tell you that they found something, but not much else! Oh, it's a bird! Uh-oh! That was the eye of the tiger. It was the thrill of the fight. Hi, Sally. I don't know, this music could use a little bit more sass. It is way too chill. Although I do like the ambience of the little crickets. But where's the honey ants? Legendary Sandbird. Didn't they have one of those in Mario 64 Sunshine Deluxe? Or was it Mario 64 Shine? It was one of those names. Super Mario 64 Shine Galaxy Party. They just add words on it endlessly. Like, what was the name of the game? Ow. We just kept adding words. And words. And words. Until there were no more words in the dictionary.
Hello.
I assume that's Infernite. Oh, please, there's gotta be a way to get into that well and get to a secret level. That is so... so predictable. Should've done it. Because it's always really fun when you find a secret level within a level. Like in the mountaintop of Mario 64 Shine Deluxe Galaxy Edition. There's like a mountain level, and if you go into a portion of the wall, just after you jump past a cloud that tries to blow you off, you get this really cool sliding level. It's part of the... like, you have to get it to get all the stars in that level, yeah. But I really like it, because it's... like, you didn't expect that. You don't come into the level thinking there's gonna be, like, a hidden area with its own music. No. It's a pleasant surprise. And there's nothing wrong with the player being pleasantly surprised. You know? There's nothing wrong with me being a happy baby. Let me be a happy baby. Don't be Nintendo. Don't try to tell me what, how, and why I can have fun. You know? And don't ever make Spring Mario a thing. Like, I liked Spring Mario for all it was worth. But I just don't want to deal with it again. Okay, I got everything except for a final fossil. There's a fossil somewhere. Good luck me, because I have no clue where to look for it. See, I had no clue where to look for it, but now I do. It's a coil. It's a spiny tendril. I guess that's a way to put it. Ooh, what's this? This looks like a button. Why are you broken, Bomb? I was told you'd be a workable bomb. That I could blow up my enemies and destroy my foes. But it seems that I'm going home an unhappy baby. couple more coins. Ah, that's always the fun part, isn't it? It's like you need a couple more, just a few more. And then you lose a couple. Which is what Wario Land did, and I actually kind of like it. Because if you have to collect 100 coins... Like, in Mario, coins were healing items. So there was a reason to just keep collecting them. But here, you lose them if you get hit. So it adds an extra layer of challenge. You know? It's like, if you make the coin limit very tight, you just can't get hurt. Not saying they should, but it's a thing they can do. Oh, I forgot to visit the old guy. The geezer. I should have gone to the sky. To the sky! Guess I'll be one medal short of the maximum. I want to go take a look at some of the challenge levels. I might not have the money to buy any, if there are any. So that will take a look at... Oh, that's cool. That's a really good one to pick. On they picked Sally. Of course they did.
Hello.
As we discussed, here's your reward.
Hello. Hello.
What are you waiting for? What are you waiting for? What are you waiting for?
Hello.
As we discussed, here's your... I like how he's so businessy about it. As we discussed, per regulation of Article 15, here is your reward. One medal that I stole from your grandfather while he was sleeping. Don't tell him I stole anything. That goes against the NDA agreement of Article 12. Meow.
Oh.
Oh. I like how excited he looks. He's all like, whoa. He's like a hippie. We finally got the final Led Zeppelin CD. Or vinyl, or whatever they call it these days. I think they call them CD-ROM diskettes. You know, it would be cool if you could get, like, in Mario they had like a little red cap, you know, like flying powers. They had the red star, the red thing in Mario Galaxy, which was really cool. That's basically functions like this. I wish that you could use that in levels. Like, you got all the things in a level, you can just use this and just fly around the level and just have a good old-fashioned time. Get those final few locations without having to worry about things. Come back with more coin. I've got no levels for ya, chump. Let's go see Naruto and see if he has any tips from the animes. Oh, I got all the challenges already. Okay. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 2, 2, 4, 5. So, there's 54 medals? Huh. Oh, there are clue stones, too. Huh. Guess we got some things to collect. Huh. So what up, Naruto? I want to take a look and see if, now that I have 100% collectibles, like... No. Wherever the clue stones are at... Mr. Old Man, do you know? Maybe they haven't implemented them yet. Like, they have the graphics, but they don't have the actual mechanics in place yet. That's alright. And I call the big giant lantern technically remains online. It really gives that sense that it's, you know, it's not a gameplay mechanic feature. It's an actual thing that it does. Let's have a quick sneakity peekity. Do like how they're always far away in the distance. Looming. Just looming at you. A lot of little details that gives the game. Looks still polish. Polish needs a lot of polish. Couple of layers, couple of iterations. Oh, we now have a headlight. Oh, that's awesome. Ah. Oh. Listen, I'll be 100% honest. I love levels with lighting mechanics like this. Although it's a little bit unwieldy, it's not perfect. But I can see the appeal. I can see this working out. Oh, these people are ghosts. Hello, spoopy man. No, it's another power outage. I hate being a ghost. I can't even activate the power buttons. I can't push the button either, sir. Can you help? Oh, so we gotta follow the wires, huh? Oh, that's awesome. Leap of faith. That's not how leaps of faith work. I'm out of here. If this actually goes somewhere. Ah, that's great. Ah, that's so good.